morning, children.
Good morning, ma'am.
So today we are going to discuss topic soil erosion and conservation. Okay. So do you know this word? What's the meaning of the word soil erosion? Any one of you? Okay. Yes, Aryan.
Ma'am, soil erosion is the process of removing the topmost soil by agent.
Okay, good. Very good. Sit down. Thank you. Oh, yes, children, he is right. Meaning of soil erosion is removal of topmost layer. That layer is fertile layer of the soil. Okay. So it can be removed by several agents. It can be wind, it can be water, it can be animals. Okay. Even we human beings are responsible for soil erosion. Right? So today we are going to discuss this topic, soil erosion. Now through two activities and one video, I will show you this process. So what is this soil erosion? So what happens, children? You know, everybody knows that roots of the plants hold soil particles together. Okay. So we can say that plants help in conservation of soil. Right? You know that due to growing population, we are cutting trees. That is called deforestation. You know, we are cutting trees in large number. So this cutting trees can be responsible for soil erosion, because if no plantation, no vegetation, soil will be barren. Okay, no crop, no grass. So what will happen? The roots are not there, so that they can hold soil particles together, so that soil becomes loose, and loose soil can be carried away by wind or water easily. So I can show you this by two activities. First activity is, I'm going to show that soil can be carried away by wind. It can be blow away by strong wind. So children, see, now I'm blowing myself. Otherwise we can use one fan. So just look here. You can see? It is blown away by the wind. Now I am going to repeat same activity with this tree. This tree having plants, as you can see, plants are there, grass is there, so roots are there. Can you see any soil? Any soil particles?
No.
So this activity shows that soil particles are bound by the what? Roots, right? Roots of the plant. Okay. Now, second activity. One more activity is there. Through that activity, we can show that this flowing water is also responsible for soil erosion. Okay. And this flowing water is largely responsible in hilly areas due to slopy area. You know, mountains are there, hills are there, so that soil can be easily flown away by the water, right? That is why what we do, we construct terrace, step farming. This step farming is very common in hilly areas. That is to avoid soil erosion. Now, so through one more activity, I am going to show you that if vegetation is not there, soil can be easily carried away by the water. See, I am putting water in this tray, having soil. See, you can see the soil becomes muddy.
Yes.
Enough? So, see, the upper layer has been carried away by water. Right? Now, same activity I am going to repeat with this tray. This tray is having grass. Okay? So, I am adding water here. Water is there, but it is less muddy if you compare it with the previous tray.
Yes.
So we can prove easily, we can see that the roots of the grass, that the roots of the plants hold soil particles together. Clear? Now I want to share a video with you. Through this video you can understand it.
Plants, crops and trees require water and soil to grow. The right amount of water keeps the ground rich and fertile. However, too much or too little water can destroy even the most fertile land. Water is one of the main reasons for soil erosion. Flowing water, as in rivers and oceans, as well as rainfall, can wash away important minerals from the topmost layer of the soil, leaving it bare and infertile. Trees cover or protect the soil beneath. Therefore, when we cut down trees, minerals and other useful parts of the topsoil are exposed to the direct attack of water and wind. Deforestation of trees means more soil erosion. Let's see if you can prevent soil erosion. Click the option that will prevent soil erosion. That's right. Using organic fertilizer for farming helps maintain the richness and fertility of the soil.
Yes, because
click the option that will prevent soil erosion. Yes, that's correct. If too many animals graze on the same ground, it reduces the soil's fertility. Farmers must control the number of animals that graze on each part of land. Click the option that will prevent soil erosion. Planting more trees will help protect the soil that lies underneath.
I hope this video was interesting as well as informative. So now children, few more points are there related to soil erosion. So first point which I want to discuss with you is deforestation. Deforestation is just opposite to afforestation. Yes, Siddharth.
Deforestation is cutting down the trees in large numbers.
Correct. So cutting down of trees in large numbers is called deforestation. We human beings are responsible for deforestation. Why? Due to growing population. We have to construct more accommodation, more flats, more buildings, malls, hospitals, schools, colleges. Okay. So due to that reason, we are cutting trees in large numbers. So opposite it, we can do afforestation. We should plant more trees, more and more trees. It's okay. We can understand due to growing population, we have to construct more buildings. But again, we need fresh air, we need food, we need other things also which we are getting from the plant. So we should grow, we should plant more trees in large number. That is called afforestation. Clear? Now, second thing is cover crops. Yes. What happens? Farmer generally, they leave their land barren in between two main crops. This barren land again is responsible for soil erosion because no plants, no roots. So cover crops in between two main crops. Like in between two cereal crops, we can grow leguminous plants. Why? There are two reasons. Number one, leguminous plants will cover the soil, okay? Resulting, we can decrease soil erosion. We cannot avoid it 100%, but we can decrease it. Number one. Number two, leguminous plants are having useful bacteria in their roots. Okay, these bacteria called leguminous bacteria, they absorb nitrogen from the atmosphere, and this nitrogen can be absorbed by the plants. Because leguminous plants are full of protein, like peas, pulses, grains, all these are good source of protein, right? From soil they cannot absorb it directly. Leguminous bacteria, they absorb nitrogen from the atmosphere, from the air, and they provide it to the plant. So this leguminous crop will add fertility to the soil, number one. Number two, it will decrease soil erosion. Clear? So this type of crop which we grow in between two main crops is called cover crop. It can be grass also. Okay? If you are not growing a leguminous crop, we can grow simply grass. Because again our main purpose is to decrease soil erosion. Right? That is cover crop. Number three, other thing which we can do to avoid, to decrease soil erosion, burns. So what is the meaning of burns? So all these, this cover crops and burns, these are the methods to decrease crop, this soil erosion. Actually burns are the boundaries along our field. So children, what we can do, what farmers can do, they are doing actually, they are making boundary wall around their field. So this boundary can prevent the movement of soil from one field to another, even though it is flooded or if it is strong wind. So most part of the soil will remain in the same field. Okay. So these burns are very very useful for avoiding soil erosion. Clear? Yes. Now, next point is overgrazing. Overgrazing by animals. You know that cattle and other animals, they used to graze in the field, in the farm. Okay. But this overgrazing of the field can be responsible for soil erosion. Because when they graze, they remove even the roots of the grass from the soil. Resultant, the soil becomes barren. So this overgrazing can be avoided. For that, we have to do many things which we will discuss later. So this overgrazing can also be avoided if we want to avoid soil erosion. Clear? So do you have any doubt related to the topic, you can ask. Any question if you want to? Yes, please. Standing. Okay, cover. Good question. Cover crops are the cover. Basically, it is clear from its name. The crop which covers the land is called cover crop. Okay, it can be grass. We can grow grass also because it will avoid, it will decrease soil erosion, right? It can be leguminous plants also, you know, because leguminous plants are useful, are beneficial by two ways. Number one, it will decrease soil erosion, and number two, it will increase the fertility of the soil. Right? Clear? So cover crop can be grass, or it can be leguminous plants. Clear? Yes. Crop rotation. Good question. Sit down. Crop rotation can can also be done for decreasing soil erosion. Children, as you rotate, see, today you are sitting the second bench. Tomorrow, where will you sit? Third one. That is rotation. So, if we grow same type of crop in the same field, what will happen? The soil will lose same type of nutrient, same type of mineral. Because that particular crop will absorb particular types of minerals from the soil. Right? So we should rotate the crop. Like now if we are growing the first type of crop, A type of crop, then next to that we can grow B type of crop. In the crop which will absorb different types of minerals, different types of nutrients. It can be any vegetation also, like any vegetation we can grow into it. Okay, because you know children, you are getting different types of minerals, nutrients from the different types of crops. What you are getting from rice or wheat, you are not getting from the pulses. Right, because pulses are absorbing that nitrogen. They are providing protein to us. And rice and wheat are providing carbohydrate to us. Okay, so that is why we should do crop rotation. So we can grow different types of crops alternatively. That is called crop rotation. Yes?
And how crop rotation is
useful?
But
a crop, sit down. Crop rotation is useful as I discussed now. If you will grow different types of crops, then the minerals which were absorbed by the previous crop can be replenished by the second type. Okay, because second type of crop will absorb different types of minerals, different types of nutrients. Like now if you are growing wheat in that crop, in that field, second time we can grow pulses in that field. Right, because pulses are having leguminous bacteria in their root nodules, in the roots. So these bacteria will increase the fertility of the soil, right? And increase in the fertility of the soil means increase in production of soil. Clear? So in this way, we can see crop rotation is beneficial for the farmer, for the nation. Okay? Any other doubt? Yes. Terrace farming. Terrace farming, what is the meaning of terrace? Meaning of terrace? Yes. Terrace farming. Another name for terrace farming is step farming. Okay. The farming which has been done on the steps. This farming, terrace farming or step farming is very common on hilly areas. Okay. Sit down. Because in hilly areas what happens? It is hilly areas is slopy. Right? Hills, mountains, these are slopy. So during rainy season, the water can be thrown very easily. Water plus minerals. Not only water. When water, the water carried away topmost layer of the soil which is fertile. Clear? That is why this step farming or terrace farming has been done in hilly areas. Okay, so what will happen, like suppose water is flowing from this side, so it will stop, it will not be completely, you can say, removed from this hill. Some part of the water, some part of the mineral will just settle down on this step. Okay, so the soil will not lose its fertility 100%. Only few part can be removed by the soil. Anything? Yes.
How is soil?
Soil is formed by the process called weathering. You know? Weathering of the soil. What happens? You just take two pieces of stone. Like suppose these are two pieces of stone. When you will rub them, what will happen? Can you see something?
Yes.
What? Some powder, but soil is there. So this is called weathering. Due to friction, due to rubbing of rocks or rock particles, and this friction can be due to strong wind or heavy water. So this due to this friction, due to rubbing of a stone, the formation of soil takes place. This process is called reddening of soil. For the formation of one centimeter. Okay, it is very slow. See, all natural processes are very slow. It can be weathering, it can be formation of fossils. Right? Sit down. So children, soil erosion is a very vast topic. Nothing which we can do through which we can avoid it by planting more and more trees through afforestation. And if possible, we should avoid cutting of trees in large number. Sometimes it is important, like construction of some island going on, some track is going through that part. So we have to cut trees. But otherwise, we have to avoid deforestation. And even though if it is very important, we cannot avoid it, then in place of that, we should plant more trees at some other place. Okay? So that is why soil erosion, we cannot avoid it completely because it is occurring naturally also. Like through?
Mom battles wind. Mom overgrazing by animals.
Yeah. Through flooding? Hello? Through flooding also? It can be thrown again?
Leaving
land barren. So we can avoid. It is in our hand. See, the natural disasters are not in our hand. We cannot control them. Right? But we can control the activities which we are doing. We can avoid them. We can decrease them. Okay? Sit down. Yes, children. I hope you understand the topic soil erosion and conservation.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what is soil erosion? I just want to ask you a question from all of you. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. So, question number one is, dash is the topmost layer of the earth.
I'm soil.
Good. Now, second question. You just raise your hand, children, then I will ask the child. Yes. Soil erosion occurs dash on barren land. Very good. Sit down. Yes. Soil erosion occurs dash. Yes. Good. Sit down. Okay. Now last question is, dash the cutting of trees in large numbers.
Ma'am, deforestation.
Deforestation. Okay. Right. Sit down. Our children, deforestation is opposite to the afforestation. Deforestation, as I have explained to you, cutting down of trees in large numbers. Okay. As we have discussed, why we are cutting trees in large numbers? Due to growing population. Right? Due to growing population, we need more flats, more buildings, more hospitals, schools and all. But in return, children, we need plants, more plants. Due to growing population, we need more food. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. So we should plant more trees. And scientific term for this growing more trees called afforestation. Okay, so these words are opposite to each other. Deforestation is cutting down of trees in large number, and afforestation means growing trees, growing plants in more numbers on large scale. Okay, because everybody knows that trees are important to us. We all depend on plants. Why? Yes, Peter, can you say?
Ma'am, because they give us food and oxygen.
Wow, very good. And of one plant? Medicinal plant?
Neem.
Neem, right. So that is why children, we can say that the plants are important part of our life. So not only for us, even for soil. Because as I told you, roots of the plants bind soil particles together.
Yes, ma'am.
So, if the plants, if the grass, then soil erosion can be minimized. It can be decreasing. We cannot stop it 100%.
Yes, ma'am.
It is not possible.
Yes, ma'am.
Because there are few natural disasters are also there. Flood is there. Huh? And other things are also there. But things which are in our hand, we can control them. What is that? Cutting of trees.
Yes.
Okay. Overgrazing by animals. And so what else we can do to stop, to decrease the soil erosion? That is? Yes? Terrace farming. Afforestation and terrace farming. Children, have you seen this step farming or terrace farming? Anyone of you? Yeah, those who are from hilly areas or those who have been to this Uttaranchal or other places, they might have seen. That is the farming is done to reduce soil erosion. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And cover crops, as I discussed with you, we can grow cover crops. In between two main crops, two cereal crops, we can grow cover crops also. That cover crop will cover the soil. Resultant, we can decrease soil erosion. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So I hope the topic is clear to you.
Yes.
And that video is very interesting, which you have seen.
Yes.
So you can go through it. Okay, children?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
All the best.
Yes.
Just go through the topic.
Yes, ma'am.
Tomorrow we will discuss next topic. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, children. Okay, children. So now we are going to discuss about the conservation of soil. Like how can we take care of soil? Okay? And one topic which is related to conservation of soil, one more. So just find out what is there. What the meaning of one more, sir? It is related to?
One more, sir. Well, One Mahotsav is a program that was initiated by the Government of India in 1950. Under this program, every year during the months of July and August, which is the rainy season, thousands of tree saplings are planted on waste land along railway tracks, roads, canals, and in towns and cities. But why was this program launched and why is it being continued even to this day? This program was initiated to help restore the ecological balance, prevent the depletion of ozone layer and conserve soil. Thus we can see that one of the aims of this program is designed to reverse the actions of soil erosion. Let us learn more about soil erosion and how soil can be conserved.
So now we are going to learn something more about conservation of soil. Already I have explained the meaning of conservation of soil, to take care of soil, okay, to protect it. Right? It's called conservation of soil.
Soil erosion means the washing away or removal of the top layers of soil by various agents. Some of the dominant agents include running water, wind, and human activities. Water, whether in the form of rain or flowing water, is a major source of soil erosion. When heavy rain occurs in regions characterized with slopes, it drags away the top layers of the soil over large areas. This is known as sheet erosion. Sometimes, rainwater carves deep paths, eroding large amounts of soil, making deep and narrow furrows along the way. This is called